So my name is Stephen Cush and I am an instructor in the physical education section here in the Garda College. When the applicants arrive at the college, they'll be met by a member of staff and brought into the lecture theatre, where they will receive a PowerPoint presentation on the exact procedure of the test day from start to finish. While there, they will also be given their assessment forms, which will they complete there before their test day. The applicants are brought to the sports hall after the PowerPoint presentation, where they are divided into groups of eight. The first group of eight will start their bleep test at 9:45 a.m. Once applicants are finished the bleep test, they will then receive a 10-minute rest period. After this rest period, they will be brought into a separate room where they will start their sit-up test. They will first give them a demonstration of the sit-ups and push-ups. After the sit-up test, they will turn over immediately and they will complete their push-ups. After the applicants have completed stage one, they then receive a 2-hour rest period, after which they are brought to the to complete a physical composite, which is stage two of the test. My advice to any person who's coming down to do the pre-entry fitness test is, firstly, prepare. As an instructor here in the college, I've noticed some applicants who've come down that possibly have never even tried the bleep test before. So my advice would be to, firstly, is to download the bleep test. It's available on thegarda.ie. Secondly, is to practice this bleep test on a regular basis. Getting familiar with the speed per each level that you may have to do, and get familiar with the test itself. The more you practice this test, the more familiar you are with the actual procedure of the test. Again, it will give you confidence. So for sit-ups and push-ups, my advice to applicants would be to get the correct technique right. Again, the technique for sit-ups, hands must remain at the temple at all times. Your shoulder blades will hit the mat on the way down, and on the upward phase, your elbows will go up as far as your knees. Practice this on a regular basis. For push-ups, for the males, their body will be in one straight line from their heels to their head. On the downward phase, their upper arms will be parallel to the floor. As they're pushing up, their arms will be fully extended. For the females, they will drop the knees with their ankles crossed behind their back. From their hips to their head, their body will move down in one straight line until their upper arms are parallel to the floor. And again, on the upward phase, they will fully extend their arms. Again, my advice would be practice, practice, practice the techniques of both sit-ups and push-ups. My advice to all applicants doing the obstacle course would be, take your time going through each obstacle. Ensure that you go through it correctly without receiving a time fault. There are certain parts of the test where you can sprint and make up time. I would advise you to sprint during these stages and take your time during the obstacles. Common obstacles that time faults are received on would be going underneath the barrier would probably be the number one. So take your time going underneath the barrier. Ensure you do it correctly. Secondly would be knocking a cone when you're maneuvering in and out between cones. Ensure not to hit the cones, and again the balance beam. So practice walking on a balance beam. If you fall off the balance beam, you will receive a slight time fault. And again, I would familiarise myself with the tests, with the obstacles and with all elements of the test before coming down here to do it. One of the most important aspects is getting the right mindset for test day. Focus solely on what you have to do yourself. Certain elements of the test will be difficult and will require determination and focus. Do not worry about what the person beside you is doing or how fast or how slow they are running. Concentrate on yourself. Practicing these tests on a regular basis will give you the confidence that you need to be successful on test day.